Hello students, this is Nitin Mahod and here in this video we are going to see the features of 8051 architecture. So it is having 8-bit CPU with accumulator register A and register B. Register A, that is accumulator register, is used for mathematical and logical operations and boolean bit manipulations. Also, it is used for all the data transfers between 8051 and any external memory, while the register B is used in combination with the accumulator for multiplication and division like operations and has no other function than data storage. The next register is data pointer register, which is written as DPTR register. It is a 16-bit wide register and it is further divided into higher byte and lower byte as DPH and DPL. DPH is higher byte of DPTR register, while DPL is the lower byte of DPTR register. Each of them are 8-bit wide. And the combination of DPH and DPL makes DPTR. What it does, it holds 16-bit external data RAM address. Then program counter register or PC, it is again a 16-bit register and it holds the address of next instruction to be executed. It holds the address of a byte in program memory and it gets automatically incremented after every instruction byte is fetched. Program counter is the only register that does not have an internal address. In 8051 microcontroller, there is an 8-bit flag register or PSW, that is program status word register, which generally provides the information about the different conditions at the different point of time when the program is being executed. Then 8-bit stack pointer register. This stack pointer register actually holds the 8-bit stack top address. Stack is the memory locations, actually one above the other. Stack can be defined anywhere in 128 byte on chip RAM, and on switching the system, that is on making the microcontroller on, the stack pointer of 8051 is initialized to 07H, means 07H is the stack top locations address by default. Then internal ROM or EPROM, which is 4 kilobytes, address range of which is from 000H to FFFH, and they are around 4096 bytes. It contains EPROM and program address registers and RAM and RAM address registers. That is, it provides on-chip EPROM and mechanism to internally address it. Similarly, 128 byte of RAM and the mechanism to internally address it. Moving on to the internal RAM structure, we have already seen the RAM, internal RAM, 128 byte RAM in the previous videos. Here we have shown it diagrammatically and we have distributed the entire 128 byte RAM into the three blocks mainly. Which are the three blocks? The register bank is one block, second block is bit addressable area, and third block is general purpose area. So we'll see it. So internal RAM consists of four register banks, each containing eight registers. So register bank 0, register bank 1, register bank 2, and register bank 3. You can consider these four banks and they make around 32 bytes. While second part is the bit addressable area, which is addressed at bit level, and it is generally useful in bit level instructions. It is around 16 bytes, while the third and the last area is a general purpose area, which is around 80 bytes. So 80 bytes plus 16 bytes plus 32 bytes, that gives the entire RAM, which is 128 byte. So this is how the internal 128 byte RAM is distributed. 32 IO pins, that is input output pins, are arranged as four 8-bit ports P0 to P3, that is P0, P1, P2 and P3. We have already seen this in the block diagram of microcontroller in the previous video. There are two 16-bit timers or counter registers, T0 and T1. These registers are accessed as their lower and upper bytes as TL0 and TH0 in case of T0 and TL1 and TH1 in case of timing register T1. So T0 is a 16-bit wide. So the higher byte of this T0 will be TH0 and the lower byte will be TL0. Similarly, the higher byte in case of T1 will be TH1 while the lower byte in case of T1 will be TL1. These registers can be accessed using four addresses allotted to them, and these addresses lie in the special function registers address range, which is from 80H to FFH. Full duplex serial data receiver or transmitter, that is SBUF it is called. It is a serial data buffer which holds the data temporarily. Actually, the temporary storage it is when data is moved from one place to another, containing two independent registers. One is a transmit buffer, which is PISO register, that is parallel in serial out register, while other is a receive buffer, that is serial in parallel out register. Loading a byte to transmit buffer starts serial transmission of that byte. If byte is written to the serial data buffer, it starts serial transmission, and if SBUF is read, it reads received serial data. So this is how the data transmission takes place through this serial buffer. Then there are different control registers like IP, that is interrupt priority, IE, that is interrupt enable, then timer mode, timer control, serial control and power control are the special function registers containing control and status information for interrupt, timer counters and serial ports. All these registers are also allotted the addresses in the special function register address range, that is 80H to FFH. Interrupt programmer can be programmed to control the interrupts. TMOD is a timer mode control register which selects either timer 0 or timer 1. TCON is a timer control register which controls the operation of counter and timers of 8051. SCON is a serial port control register or serial control register, and PCON is a power control register which is used in power management. There are two external and three internal interrupt sources in 8051. Oscillator and clock circuit. Using crystal oscillator, the circuit generates basic timing clock signal for the operation of the circuit. And last but not the least is ALU, that is arithmetic logic unit, which performs 8-bit arithmetic and logical operations on the operands, that is data, held by the temporary registers TMP1 and TMP2. And user cannot access these temporary registers. So these are the 12 features of the 8051 microcontroller. I hope you must have understood all this, because you must have gone through the microprocessors also. You must have gone through the 8085, 8086, and now we are studying 8051. So naturally, the concepts are same, only the difference is features will be different. So far, the microprocessor and microcontrollers are concerned. Here, 8051 microcontroller features we have studied through this video. I hope you have understood the concept. Thank you.